The future of the Great Barrier Reef is looking brighter as well this morning, with scientists making a breakthrough that's as simple as it is exciting.
It couldn't come at a better time for the reef, as today's Ashlyn Krukellis explains in this exclusive report.
I mean, unfortunately, 2020 is being a difficult year, a challenging year for many of us, and it has been a challenging year for the Great Barrier Reef.
While we've been busy fighting bushfires and coronavirus, our reef has been facing a fight of its own.
It sort of snuck up on us a little bit because we were distracted by everything else, but it ended up being a very severe event.
It suffered widespread coral bleaching, the third event of its kind in 5 years, and some say the worst yet.
When you see a reef that's bleached, it's showing signs of stress. The stress now is because the temperature of the water is so high.
There couldn't be a better time for the reef to be thrown a lifeline. And this one comes in the form of an exciting discovery.
It's a brilliant breakthrough.
In a lab, a team of scientists from Australia, the UK, US and Brazil tried giving a variety of coral species probiotics, just like those many of us take for our own health. The results are remarkable.
In every single test, that all the corals that had been fed the probiotics had a stronger survival rate. So they were tougher, they were healthier, and they were able to survive and thrive.
The process is simpler than you might think. The way we usually take probiotics is through our diet, by eating yogurt or having certain drinks. The method is the same for coral.
They've been able to grow these microbials inside zooplankton, which is the natural food of corals. So the idea is the corals are just eating their food, but their food has been turbocharged with probiotics. And I mean, I can't help but jump forward. Imagine if, you know, ahead of a summer event when we know it's going to be hot, we could essentially give the Great Barrier Reef a flu shot.
The next step is to replicate the success on the reef itself. It's been cared for in recent months by tour operators who've been out of work. They're getting it ready for visitors to return with a new appreciation for all we've got.
For me, COVID has taught us that we don't need to travel as much as we have been doing. And I think that there's so much exciting science happening right now about the health of reefs that when we put both of these things together, we can still have beautiful reefs in the future.
A lot of good people working to save the reef up there, don't you?
Yeah, the Great Barrier Reef Foundation, I think, does an extraordinary job. And you might have seen in the last 24 hours too, I mean, even those shots of the turtles, I think 60,000 turtles, just even tracking that, which they're doing.
Yeah.
And this probiotic stuff, the research with DNA and corals is fascinating. And just go to their website to check it all out. But it really is they're hoping that the future of the reef is more assured with that kind of research, and it looks that way.